Shortly after the death of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, something very mysterious happened in that part of the world that historians have chosen to bury. A tribe called the Khazar, chose to embrace Judaism. And so the world witnessed for the first time the very strange phenomenon of a non-Semitic people becoming Jews. Non-Semitic becoming Jews. The genetic research is available on the internet. Anyone can study it. You had conferences, medical conferences, which were organized to study these people, their genetic composition. They had a genetic composition which was unique in all of mankind. No people in the world were like them. This is scientific research. And these people, the Khazar, chose to convert to Judaism, but they did so not for any religious reasons. They were not so much interested in the Kitab and to follow the law. They embraced Judaism for purposes of political expediency. They were sandwiched between Islam and Christianity, Byzantine Christianity, and they chose Judaism. These European Jews, who have no racial, biological connection with the Banu Israel, multiply. وَهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ حَلَبٍ يَنْسِلُونَ Nasl, they multiplied and multiplied and breeded to such an extent that today nine in every 10 Jews in the world, 90% or more, are European Jews. They outnumber the Semitic Jews by 9 to 1 or 10 to 1. These European Jews, if you look at the list of names of Nobel Prizes for science, for literature, when you name it, you will find that these are people who far exceed the rest of mankind in their intellectual brilliance, in their academic achievements, in their scientific research. They are a people different from the rest of mankind. And then you find that these Khazar, who became Jews, also chose to become Christians. So you have the Khazar infiltrating the camp of Judaism and infiltrating the camp of Christianity as well. And from the ranks of these Khazar Jews and Khazar Christians, the emergence of the Jewish-Christian alliance can be traced. It is this Jewish-Christian alliance, Khazar, which eventually gives birth to the Zionist movement. The Zionist movement has absolutely nothing to do with Banu Israel. It is an essentially and an exclusively European achievement. It is these Khazar who, having become Jews, first Jews and second Christians, who built an empire that was the most powerful in Europe and Central Asia. And when the armies of Islam had simultaneously defeated the two superpowers in the world, the Persian Empire and Byzantium, and had emerged as the most powerful military force in the world, Khazar blocked our way. We could not defeat them. And so it would be quite correct to say that the Khazar demonstrated a military power without equal in the world at that time. It is from this part of the world that they spread out. They spread out to Eastern Europe, they spread to Russia, and eventually crossed the sea to the United States. And they are at the heart of the revolutions which transformed Europe from Christendom into modern Western civilization. They are at the heart of the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia, which overturned Christianity in Russia. They are at the heart of the French Revolution, in consequence of which the back of the Christian church is broken. The prohibition of riba is now consigned to the garbage bin. And they are at the heart of the creation of the Zionist movement. It is these Khazar, Jewish and Christian, who now move to the Holy Land, assisted by a strange and mysterious Jewish Holocaust. And the history of that will one day be revealed on Judgment Day. How much was their input into the Holocaust? So that you have an exodus now of these European Jews to the Holy Land. When the State of Israel comes into being, who it is who controls power in Israel? Not the Oriental Jews, the darker skinned Jews. No, they are second class citizens. The ones who control power in Israel are the European Jews.
Appropriately. I've been in Yemen, in Morocco, in the Jewish communities. In all the communities, Jews have been living up to the creation of the State of Israel, till Zionism came about rather around 100 years ago. They have been living in peace without any human rights groups watching us. It is not a religious conflict on the continent. Not a religious conflict on the continent. Not a religious conflict on the continent.
There is no specific discrimination against Palestinian Christians as opposed to Palestinian Muslims. It's a shared suffering. Palestinian Christians have difficulty getting to churches on Sunday morning if they wanted to come to Jerusalem because they don't have that permission or that legal right, according to the Israeli government, to come to Jerusalem for worship.
The European Christians and European Jews, there will be those who become Muslims, there will be those who are our friends and allies. Do not make the mistake of declaring of all Jews that they are your enemies and all Christians they are your enemies. That will be quite foolish.